Hello and welcome to another one of my videos. In this one we're going to be looking at measurements. Just recently I've been planing down bits of wood quite thin to under 2 millimeters, and I needed to measure it because I found that even a half a millimeter made the difference between a difficult bend or not. And so I needed to be able to measure it to see how close to the measuring I could get. Now I therefore used my micrometer here. It does give me down to tenths of a millimeter. It gives millimeters here and tenths here, but in the light and with my eyes, and aren't quite so good these days, I could not quite read those accurately enough, and I was getting half a millimeter out of precision. So I needed a method of measuring a lot more accurately. So I did some research on the internet into the theory of micrometers and came up with this design of my own for an emergency. It does get down to a tenth of a millimeter accuracy quite happily. So here's the theory. For mechanical micrometers, before you go digital, this is more or less how it goes. If you have a thread, there are classifications of threads, how many threads per inch or per centimeter. In the case of this thread here, I'm fortunate enough to have 10 threads per centimeter. I can measure them and count them up. Just to be more accurate, I'll measure 3 centimeters worth, and I've got 30, divide that by 3, and that confirms that I have 10 threads per centimeter. That means one turn of that means it will advance or retract by 1 millimeter. And if we go precisely, if you go half a turn, that's half a millimeter. If you go a quarter of a turn, that's a quarter of a millimeter. And then you can sort of judge between that how many millimeters. So, to put it into practice, I can get a little piece of board like this on the corner here, tighten it until it's not too tight so that you can actually move it and take it out. Until it's snug but not too tight, pull it out. So remembering that that's the starting point here. Now if I go around once, that's 1 millimeter, 2 millimeters, and then it goes another half, means 2.5, plus a little bit more, maybe 2.6, 2.7 millimeters thick, 2.7 at that point. But if you don't have one like that, where you're fortunate enough to have that many teeth, you can make one. So what bolts do we have available? These Dyna bolts here that I picked up, they don't have a head, and they have, this one has 7 threads per centimeter, and that's basically what I made this one out of. I bored a hole in it and put that thing through just to be able to turn it. That's a possibility. Another one is this one here. It has 7 per centimeter as well, but it's a little bit bent on the end, so I won't use that one. This one here is a high tensile one, and it has one of those heads rather than the other heads, and it is also 7 per centimeter. Although I have this one here, which has 10 threads per centimeter, that's 1 per millimeter. That gives me the same results as this, or it would do. But for this exercise, let's use this one because the calculation of the threads is going to be different, because you're going to have 7 turns per centimeter, so that one turn is not 1 millimeter, it's 1.4. So let's do that anyway. And the first thing to do is the wooden piece here, the casing that it's going to go into. So preferably some hardwood, but just an offcut. We're going to measure there and where it's going to end up and the gap that we're going to be able to get from there to make a U-shape like that. Cut that out and cut that off. I'm going to put a hole through here, but later on. So let's cut that first. So there that is, and the hole there is just the right size for it to fit snugly. I've waxed it so that it will screw in snugly, and right into the end, so that it's going to just touch there and make a little bit of a dent or a mark there to say where it ends up. Then I'm going to back it off, and then in that little mark there that it has made, indentation, I'm going to put a thumbtack. That's so that we have a metal on metal contact, so that we get a more precise touch when it's measuring, and also want to make sure that the end of that bolt, sometimes it's not very clean on the end, so we want to flatten that off or give it a slight curve so that you're getting a precise touch when you do your measuring. And running that on some sandpaper will probably do that for me. The next thing is the dial to read the measurements. It's going to be made out of a piece of card, wood or plywood or something, with a hole in the middle, and attach it. I'm going to glue it and probably put a little nail in there just to attach it on, so that it goes there. Now, because we have 7 teeth and 1 centimeter is 10 millimeters, you're going to be dividing the 10 divided by 7 equals 1.4. 1.4. That means that a circle of there in one turn is going to be 1.4 millimeters. So we can divide this into 14 pieces so that we can get the tenths of a millimeter there. So using some precise dividers, we can adjust that and find out what 14 steps looks like. And just to save time, there we have our 14 steps as that distance, and then mark them off. And there they are. Now you're going to wind that right in so that it's touching that, and then you're going to need a pointer. So what I'm going to do is just get a piece of wire, wrap it round, and either glue, tape, or fix it somehow so that it's basically fixed on there. Now I've just used some tape for the moment, but I think I'll epoxy glue it on there so it's a little bit steadier, so that that will turn as it unscrews. So now to measure something. Here's a board which has some slight variations in it. So let's just try a generic place, just place it between there, wind it down until it's snug, and you can pull it out. Okay, then remember which point it is pointing at here. And then if we wind it in until it closes, you'll get the measurement. So you remember, one full turn is going to be 1.4. Two full turns is going to be 2.8. But at that point, it doesn't reach it at 2.8, 2.765, 2.5 millimeters. So let's try another place. I think the thickest part of that is somewhere around here, I believe. Wind it in until it's snug. It's a little tight. Yep. Remembering which of those points it's on, then I'm going to wind it once is 1.4 millimeters, twice is 2.8, and 2.9, and 3. 3 millimeters exactly, I know that point is. And I have actually taken that, this piece here, this, and not quite that, but and measured that with industrial calipers, micrometers, and this is as accurate as the mechanical ones of good grade before you get to the digital ones. So that's pretty decent. It's good enough for me. I can get down to a tenth of a millimeter accuracy.